वेलकम टू माई फोर्थ लेक्चर ऑन टाइम सीरीज. सो हियर वी शैल डिस्कस द एस्टिमेशन ऑफ मीन फंक्शन, ऑटोकोवेरियंस फंक्शन एंड ऑटोकोरिलेशन फंक्शंस एंड देयर सैम्पलिंग डिस्ट्रीब्यूशंस. नाउ we have a time series and particularly we have a stationary time series, and having a mean mu, and from this time series we have n observations z1 z2 zn. And the population autocovariance function is gamma k, and autocorrelation function is rho k. So on the basis of these n observations z1, z2, zn, we shall estimate the mu, this gamma k autocovariances and autocorrelations rho k. So when we have the observations z1, z2, zn, n observations, an estimate of the population mean mu is given by the sample mean z bar, that is equal to 1 by n t equal to 1 to n zt. So this is an unbiased estimate of the population mean, because the expectation of the sample mean z bar equal to mu. Now what will be the variance? Now variance of z bar, that will equal to variance of 1 by n t equal to 1 to n zt, and that is equal to 1 by n square n I t equal to 1 to n and s equal to 1 to n covariance of zt, and zs, that is 1 by n square t equal to 1 to n, s equal to 1 to n, gamma t minus s. Now here 1 by n square, so this is t equal to 1 to n, and when s less than t, that is also 1 to n, so this is gamma t minus s. Here t equal to s, 1 to n. And here t equal to 1 to n, s is greater than t, gamma t minus s. Now this is equal to 1 by n square. So when s is less than t, t minus s is positive. So this will be k equal to 1 to n minus 1, n minus k into gamma minus k, and this is s equal to t, so this is t minus s becomes equal to 0, and here t minus s, here s is greater than t, so t minus s, this is negative, so n minus k gamma k. So now this is your gamma k equal to gamma minus k. It is symmetric. So this is middle term, k equal to 1 to n gamma 0. That will be equal to n into gamma 0 plus first and last term. These two will be 2 into k minus k equal to 1 to n, n minus k gamma k. And we know that population autocorrelation of lag k, rho k, that is equal to gamma k by gamma 0, and this rho k equal to rho minus k. So these two first and last term will be same, and this will be 2 into this. So now this is gamma 0 taking common, so the gamma 0 by n, this is 1 plus 2 So n minus k by n, this is 1 minus k by n, n by n is 1 k by n, and this is gamma k by gamma 0, so this is rho k. Now this is the variance of z bar. Now this is variance divided by n number of observation. If z1, z2, zn they are independent, then variance of z bar will be this much, gamma 0 by n. But because of the special property of dependence relationship among the values of the time series, here the variance of z bar is gamma 0 by n into this. So here variance of z bar, that is equal to gamma 0 by n whole into 1 plus 2 k equal to 1 to n minus 1, 1 minus k by n into rho k. Now here n into variance of z bar, that is equal to gamma 0 into this. Now this is gamma 0 into, when n is very large and we can say this k equal to 1 to infinity rho k, mod of rho k is finite. So k, n is large means 1 minus k by n tends to 0. So this is 1. So I equal to 1, k equal to 1 to infinity, this will be rho k as n tends to infinite. And thus the large sample variance of z bar is given by variance of z bar equal to gamma 0 by n into this. Now hence, here the variance of z bar has two parts. One is, first part is gamma 0 by n, and the second part it's 1 plus this 2 summation k equal to 1 to n minus 1, 1 minus k by n into rho k. Now the first part gamma 0 by n is the usual variance of the sample mean z bar if the observations are independent. But the second part, it is due to the dependence of this observation, that is the presence of autocorrelation among the values of ZT. So this second term, when the autocorrelations are present, they can affect the precision of the sample mean. So when there is a stationary process of autocorrelation rho k, that is equal to phi to the power, suppose k, phi less than 1, the large sample approximation to this variance becomes gamma 0 by n into this. So the second term, the factor 1 plus phi into gamma divided by 1 minus phi, the second factor obviously differ from 1. So this is the effect due to the presence of autocorrelation among the observations. So now see, if the k equal to 1 to infinity gamma k is the autocorrelation of lag k, this mod less than infinity, then the stationary time series ZT has a spectral density function f, and n into variance of ZT that will tend to k equal to 1 to infinity gamma k, that is equal to 2 pi f0. F0, it is the value of the spectral density function at 0. Again, if suppose z t equal to mu plus j equal to minus infinity to plus infinity, psi j a t minus j, with a condition mod psi j less than infinity, j equal to minus infinity to plus infinity, and k equal to minus infinity to plus infinity, gamma k less than 1. So this condition is mostly satisfied by the moving average process. So here n into variance of z bar will tends to k equal to minus infinity to plus infinity gamma k, so that will be also equal to 2 pi f0, and this is 2 pi f0 equal to sigma a square into this, j equal to 1 to infinity psi j square. Now if gamma n tends to n0 as n tends to infinity, then z bar convergence in mean to mu. Moreover, under the more stronger condition, that when gamma k equal to minus infinity to plus infinity, this mostly satisfied, this condition is mostly satisfied the autoregressive moving average processes. And here in this case, variance of ZT follows, becomes similar to 1 by n summation k equal to minus infinity to plus infinity gamma k. So Z bar, the sample mean, it follows the asymptotically normal distribution. Why it is asymptotically? Because it is for large sample distribution when n tends to infinity. The sample mean follows the asymptotically normal distribution with population mean, with mean mu and variance 1 by n summation k equal to minus infinity to plus infinity gamma k. So this is mostly for the autoregressive and moving average processes. Now we can have detailed proof of these. You can refer, I will suggest a book at the end of this lecture. You can go through the detail in that book. So here now we find the distribution of sample mean, that is, if ZT is a stationary time series and ZT is in this form mu plus j equal to minus infinity to plus infinity psi j a t minus j, where a t, they are iid random variables with zero mean, variance sigma a square, and they satisfy the coefficients psi j, they satisfy these two conditions. J varying from minus infinity to plus infinity, mod of psi j is finite, the sum of the coefficients is finite, absolute value of the coefficients is finite, and the second, for all the values phi j, the sum of all the coefficients, that is non-zero. So in this case, the sample mean z bar follows asymptotically normal distribution with mean mu and the variance 1 by n nu, where nu equal to this summation gamma k. So this summary just we have discussed previously. So now this is the estimation of mean and its variance. So now let us discuss the estimation of the autocovariance. The population autocovariance is gamma k, and there are so many estimators exist, but the most useful one is due to Jenkins and Watts. In 1968 they have suggested this, and an estimator of the population autocovariance of lag k, gamma k, is ck. So where ck is the sample auto covariance. So ck equal to 1 by n minus k t equal to 1 to n zt minus z bar zt plus k minus z bar, where k equal to 0 to 1 to up to k equal to n minus 1. But here, in place of taking n minus k, it is better to take 1 by n. So ck, this is for all practical purpose, because sometimes by taking 1 by n minus k, this estimator becomes unreliable. So they suggested, instead of taking this n minus k, we take n minus k, 1 by n only, not n minus k. So this is the estimate of the auto covariance of lag k. And since the autocorrelation, if you divide autocovariance by the variance term ck by c0, sample autocovariance of lag k by sample variance, so that becomes an estimate of the population autocorrelation or rho k. So this is the sample autocorrelation gives an estimate of the population autocorrelation rho k. So here we take k equal to 0, 1, 2 up to n minus 1. Why it is n minus 1? Suppose we have 10 values, sample values. So we can define suppose autocorrelation, sample autocorrelation of lag 1. Lag 1 means in the first series we have Z1 to Z9 and second Z2 to Z10. 1-1 difference. So here we have 9 pairs. So we can estimate from these 9 pairs, we can estimate C1 and row 1. So this is sample autocorrelation of lag 1. Similarly, suppose lag 2, we take the values 2-2 apart. So first series starts from Z1 to Z8 and second series Z3 to Z10. So here we have 8 pairs. So similarly, the last we can have, suppose autocorrelation of lag 9, then what will be the value? Only we have 2 values. First series will be Z1 and the second only one pair here we have Z1 and Z10 differences. So from only one pair we cannot estimate the autocovariance. So similarly, suppose lag of 8. So here how many pairs? First series will be Z1, Z2 and the second will be Z9 and Z10. Only two pairs. So in this case, what happens when the lag becomes very close to the number of observations? We have 10 observations and the lag here we are considering line lag 8. So when the lag becomes closer to the number of observations, that is becomes very large, even though we can estimate by using the formula, but these estimates are not reliable because a smaller number of pairs are there. So they suggested when there are n observations, the lag should be at least n by 4. So that means if we have 40 observations, we should consider the lag up to 10. 40 by 4 lag auto covariances and auto correlations of lag 1, lag 2 up to lag 10. So now if this Ck that is equal to 1 by n, I equal to 1 to n, Zt minus Z bar, Zt minus K minus Z bar, this gives an estimate of gamma K. So what will be its distribution? Similarly, what will be the distribution of Rk? Because Ck and Rk are the sample autocovariances. So here only the difference, in place of this 1 by n minus k, we shall take 1 by n, not 1 by n minus k. So first let us consider the sampling distribution of sample autocovariances. Now for this sampling distribution, we have imposed some conditions on the moving average process. The first conditions on the time series, the first condition is the ZT, it is a moving average process. The second condition, it can be written in the form ZT equal to J equal to minus infinity to plus infinity psi J into AT minus J. So here AJ, the sequence are IID with zero mean and variance sigma square, and the coefficients they satisfy this condition, their sum of the coefficients, sum of the absolute value of the coefficients is finite. And another condition, expectation of AT to the power 4, fourth order moment of these random variables AJ, this is equal to eta into sigma A to the power 4. And this is finite. So under these conditions, the sample autocovariance matrix C, this is asymptotically normal with mean population autocovariance matrix gamma and variance or the dispersion matrix N inverse V, where this C sample autocorrelation matrix is a K plus 1 order matrix containing C0, C1, C2 up to CK this transpose, and this gamma is equal to gamma 0, gamma 1, gamma K, and this V is equal to eta minus 3, this eta minus 3 gamma P into gamma Q plus this summation J equal to minus infinity to plus infinity gamma J minus P plus Q gamma J plus P gamma J minus P, where PQ taking values 0 to K. So this is the distribution. So now since we have, this is the dispersion matrix, this matrix should be non-negative definite. So for this, we should have the sample autocovariance matrix that should be also non-negative definite. So we have to prove this matrix C that is a non-negative definite. So for this, we have to verify the gamma estimate of gamma that is C, that is N inverse T into T dash, where T is a N in cross 2N matrix. Now here we take T in this form. So first we take capital N number of zeros, then the values Z1, Z2, Zn minus 1, Zn, then here first N minus 1 zeros in the second row, then starts from the observation Z1 to Zn, then last one 0. So then here first N minus 2 zeros and Z1, Z2, Zn, then last 2 zeros. So like this, first Z1, Z2, Zn and then N zeros. So here we have 2N columns and N rows, and these values Z1, Z2, these values are corrected from their mean. So that means Zi minus Z bar. So here we have for every N cross 1 vector A, we have A gamma cap estimate of gamma, A dash gamma estimate A equal to A dash C. A gamma estimate is the sample covariance matrix C, that is equal to N inverse A dash T transpose. So this is greater than equal to 0. This is in the form of sum of squares. So this is always greater than equal to 0. So our sample autocovariance matrix C is non-negative definite, and sample autocovariance matrix that is just equal to C by C0. C0 is the variance. So this is also positive. So C is non-negative definite. So 1 by C0 into C, this is also non-negative definite. So sample autocorrelation matrix also non-negative definite. So thus we have C greater than 0 and R greater than 0. C is the matrix of sample autocovariances and R is the matrix of sample autocorrelations. So now for details proof, there you can refer this book, Time Series Theory and Methods by Brockwell and Davis. So there is a complete chapter 7. So you can go through this. I am only summarizing the results here because these are useful for your competitive exams. So I am only noting down the results about the important distributions of the sample correlations and sample auto covariances. I am not going to the proof in detail. So now there is a theorem regarding the distribution of the sample autocorrelations. Sample autocorrelations. So here Zt is a stationary process such that Zt equal to psi J A T minus J, where A J, where I I D random variables, and the same condition there, only the expectation of at to the power 4 in the previous case, it was eta sigma to a to the power 4, but it is only finite. So this condition is a little bit relaxed in case of this autocorrelation. Then for each k, we have this distribution Rk is asymptotically normal with Pk and N inverse W. Pk is the population autocorrelation matrix and W is Wij. So here Rk is R1, R2, Rk, this is correlations. R0 is not there because R0 autocorrelation of lag 0, this is always equal to 1. So Rk, this is R1, R2, Rk, sample autocorrelations of lag 1, lag 2, lag k. And this Pk is the population autocorrelations lag 1, lag 2, lag k. So rho 1, rho 2, rho k. And the covariance matrix W, that is equal to this using Bartlett's formula. So here this is the way you can remember very easily. So this is H equal to 1 to infinity rho, this is H plus I, H minus I, minus 2 rho I rho H into, in place of I, here I am writing only J, rho H plus J plus rho H minus J, minus 2 rho J rho H. So this, the second line, this is easier to remember. So this is the, gives the variance and covariance matrix between this for this autocorrelations. So when I equal to J, we get a variance of this Ri. When I not equal to J, we get the covariance between Ri and Rj. Now some special cases, we now write down some of the summaries which are useful for doing the problems, particularly short questions. So first, for the sample mean, I am writing this estimate of the sample mean is Z bar, just summarizing whatever we have discussed in previous slides. So Z bar is the sample mean and its variance is this. It consists of two parts. The first part is usual variance if the Zi's are independent, and the second part, it is due to the interdependence or the autocorrelation between the Z values. So this is due to the special property of the time series. And this Z bar, this follows asymptotically normal with mean mu and variance sigma Z square, where sigma Z square is this. This is the large sample variance that we have already discussed. For large n, this variance equal to this. Now for sample autocovariance Ck, now gamma k cap equal to Ck equal to 1 by n. So I equal to 1 to n, Zi minus Z bar, Z t plus k minus Z bar, t equal to 1 to n. So here in place of n minus k, I am writing n, because in, if we write n minus k, we may get unreliable results that we have already discussed. So this is 1 by n into this, and under these conditions for moving average processes, these are the usual conditions for satisfied by the moving average process. Only the additional expectation of at to the power 4 equal to eta sigma a to the power 4. So this is the restriction or the fourth moment of this white noise process. So under these conditions, the Ck, the autocovariance of lag k, sample autocovariance of lag k, is asymptotically normal with mean that is equal to the population autocovariance of lag k and variance vk. So here vk is equal to variance of ck. So this is asymptotically equal to 1 by n. This is eta minus 3 gamma k square plus j equal to minus infinity to plus infinity gamma j square plus gamma I plus k into gamma sorry gamma j plus k into gamma j minus k, and this is the variance of sample autocovariance of lag k, and the covariance between any two sample autocovariances. So covariance between CP and CQ, some covariance between the sample autocovariance of lag P and lag Q, CP and CQ, that is equal to PQth element of B that we have already discussed previously. So that is eta minus 3 into gamma P into gamma Q. So gamma P, gamma Q, these are the population autocovariances of lag P and lag Q. And j equal to minus infinity to plus infinity, this is gamma j into gamma j minus p plus q plus gamma j plus q and j minus p. So this is for the sample autocovariances, and then for sample autocorrelations, same we have n values. And autocorrelation of lag k, sample autocorrelation of lag k is rk, that is ck by c0, and jt is a stationary process. The same condition, only the restriction and the fourth order moment, that is finite. So this is little bit relaxing than the restriction on this fourth order moment in autocovariances. So this is the Bartlett's formula, and this is the variance of RK is WK, and the expectation of RK is rho K, and the variance of RK is WK, where WK equal to this 1 by N, H equal to 1 to infinity, rho H plus K plus rho H minus K minus 2 rho K rho H whole square, and covariance between Ri and Rj, that is equal to 1 by n, h equal to 1 to infinity, this rho h plus I, rho h minus I minus 2, rho I rho h plus j, rho h minus j, rho j rho h, in place of just, I am replacing j in place of I for the second term. So this is the square term, this is I, j separate. So these two, they are easily to remember, so you can use them for practical purposes. So now take a simple autoregressive process, most simple process, autoregressive process of order 1, first order autoregressive process, in which the rho k, the autocorrelation of lag k, that is equal to phi to the power k r mod. This we shall calculate when we shall study in detail about the autoregressive process of first order autoregressive process. So in that lecture I will show you how rho k equal to phi to the power mod k. Now here, now variance of rk, rk is the sample autocorrelation of lag k. So by using this Bartlett's formula, rho h plus k rho h minus k minus 2 rho h rho k whole square. So rho h plus k, that will be equal to phi to the power mod h plus k plus this rho h minus k will be equal to phi mod h minus k minus 2. This is rho k. So this will phi mod k, phi to the power mod k, this is phi to the power mod h, this is whole square. So now this h equal to 1 to infinity, so this is phi h minus k mod, this is, since h k are positive, phi to the power mod h plus k, that is equal to phi here the power phi mod h plus mod k. So phi h minus k mod, and this is minus phi h plus k mod whole square. This is not 2. This is not 2, so only phi h minus k minus phi h plus k whole square. Now this is 1 by n, I h equal to 1 to n, phi k minus h minus phi k plus h whole square. So 2 is not here, this is a mistake. 2 will not be here. So phi k minus h minus phi k plus h whole square plus, I am writing here 2, but since it is h minus k, so h minus k r mod k value may be greater than, so h value h equal to 1 to infinity and k is fixed, so h value may be less than k or may be greater than k, accordingly mod of h minus k will be positive or negative. So I am dividing it into two parts, h equal to 1 to k, then k plus 1 to infinity. So the first part here, phi to the power 2k and phi to the power minus h, phi to the power h whole square. Here phi to the power k minus h, phi to the power k plus h. So phi to the power k taking common from these two. So from square, so this will be phi to the power 2k. Only we have left phi to the power minus h, phi to the power plus h whole square plus 1 by n. Now from these two, we can take, because h minus k, this is here positive, so phi to the power h we can take outside, phi to the power h square, so phi to the power 2h. So only left we have phi to the power minus k minus phi to the power k. So now this will be equal to 1 by n phi to the power 2k, and this is a minus b whole square formula. Now here also I am writing a minus b whole square, a square plus b square minus 2ab. Now then here I am phi to the power 2k taking out of the summation sign, so and then summation for each terms, and here also like, so this is independent of h, so it will be good outside the summation sign, so we have only h equal to k plus 1 to infinity phi to the power 2h. Now this will be equal to this, I am writing it again. So here 1 by n phi to the power 2k, so phi to the power minus 2h, so this is a geometric series, so phi to the power minus 2, so 1 minus phi to the power minus 2k by 1 minus phi to the power minus 2. So we have a geometric series a plus ar plus ar square plus up to so on plus ar to the power n minus 1 equal to a whole into 1 minus r to the power n divided by 1 minus r. So using that, so a equal to phi to the power minus 2, r is also equal to phi to the power minus 2, I am writing this. So in place of n terms, we have k terms here. So similarly, I am using this geometric expression, I am finding the sum here. So now, from the second term, this is 1 minus phi square, phi to the power 2k plus 1, I multiply here. Now, this here I add the first two terms and second term I keep as it is. Now here this minus 2k, this will minus 2k into phi to the power 2k, this will be, I am keeping it outside, and this first term with the this third term I am adding LCM 1 minus phi square. So these two terms will cancel, phi to the power 4k plus 2. Now we have this 1 by n into this, and that is equal to 1 by n. Here 1 plus phi square, and the from the first and fourth term we can take common phi to the power 2k. So this will be 1 plus phi square again. Then this will be 1 plus phi square whole into 1 minus phi to the power 2k by 1 minus phi square minus this. So this is the result, and when k is very large, so this term will be approximately equal to 1. This will be very small because phi is less than 1, mod of phi lies between 0 to 1. So this will be very small and tends to 0, we can have only 1 plus phi square by 1 minus phi square. So this is the variance of RK for autoregressive series of first order AR1 series. Now it has a special property that in particular if k equal to 1, that means we consider the autocorrelation of lag 1, then using k equal to 1 here in this expression, we get variance of R1 that is approximately equal to 1 by n 1 minus phi square. This is the large sample variance of R1. R1 means the sample autocorrelation of lag 1. So now take some another particular case. So if we have a auto any process with autocorrelations rho h equal to 0 for all autocorrelation of lag h which are greater than q. So then from Bartlett approximation of the variance that we have, so this is, so by simplification we can get 1 by n. This is straightforward, just find the square and simplify as before. You can get 1 by n, 1 plus this 1, this will be rho 0, rho 0 is 1, and 1 plus, and this is 1 to q, so rho h rho square. And covariance between rk and rk plus s, that will be approximately equal to 1 by n, so h equal to minus q to q into this. So here k is greater than q. So now these two formula is applicable for any process with autocorrelation rho k rho h equal to 0 for all h greater than q. That means lag more than q. So now consider a completely random series, that is a white noise process. White noise process, they are all the terms are there independent, and so all the autocorrelations of order q greater than 0 are 0. So in this case, using the above result, we have the, so all these are 0, so rows will be 0, only here 1 by n, and this term will be 0, that means they are independent. So variance of RK, that is approximately equal to 1 by n only, because this term will be 0 second term. So 1 by n, so its standard error will be approximately equal to 1 by root over of n. So this is the standard error and the covariance for a white noise process. That means all the terms are independent and k is greater than 0. Since it is independent, all the autocorrelations of lag k are 0. But these are RK and RK, RK plus S, that these are the sample auto correlations. But population auto correlation is 0 because it is a white noise process, the terms are independent. But sample auto correlations that we are calculating on the basis of sample, so it may not be always equal to 0. So because RK, the sample autocorrelations, they are independent with mean 0 and standard error, standard deviation 1 by n. So this is important. N is the number of observations. So for a white noise process, the distribution of the sample autocorrelation of lag K is asymptotically normal with mean 0. And variance only 1 by n, n is the number of observation. Now take a sample, random sample of size 200 from a process with known autocorrelation of lag 1, that is equal to minus 0.4. This is our population autocorrelation of lag 1, this is minus 0.4. This is known, and rho k equal to 0 for all k greater than 1. So this is known. From this process, we select randomly 200 observations. So assuming that the series is completely random, we find that the standard error of RK is 1 by root over of n, 1 by root over of 200, that is 0.07. Now, we calculate different sample autocorrelations of lag K. So, here R1 we calculate minus 0.38, R2 minus 0.08, R3 0.11, so like this. So, we calculate. Then we can see if we consider 3 sigma limits for R1, so 3 sigma limits, 3 sigma, 3 into 0.07, so minus 0.21 to plus 0.21, so R1 does not lie in this range, R is outside. So, we cannot say the R1 as is 0. So, but all other RI values, they can be treated as 0. So, there lies between this. So, therefore, we have sufficient evidence to believe that the process is not a white noise process. Because if it would be a white noise process, all the autocorrelations must be close to 0. So, this is not a white noise process. So, our assumption that it is completely random, this is not true, that we are not getting support from the sample. Sample is showing that R1 is minus 0.38, which cannot be considered as 0 because this is not lying in this range. So, our assumption that it is a complete white noise process, it is not true. So, it has a non-zero value, rho 1. Moreover, the estimated autocorrelations for lag greater than 1, means rho 2 to rho 10, all these, they are very small. Therefore, we can believe that process is not random. So, rather we can go for another hypothesis that rho 1 is not equal to 0, but rho k is equal to 0, k greater than equal to 2. So, the sample values is helping us to find the order of the lag of the series, to what extent the values are dependent. So, here we get rho 1 not equal to 0. So, the values are dependent at lag 1. So, instead of considering all are completely random, we have taken this. Instead of considering, we are considering rho 1 not equal to 0. So, we are using q equal to 1. So, Bartlett approximation we are again using. So, this is 1 by n, 1 plus h equal to 1 to q rho h. So, q is equal to 1. So, here it is only rho 1. One term, rho 1 equal to minus 0.38, so in square it will be same 0.38 into this 0.0064, so k greater than 1. So, variance of RK is this. So, now, so standard error of RK is its root over, so variance of RK is 0.08. So, here the estimated autocorrelation for lags greater than 1 are all small with this standard error 0.08. So, there is no reason to doubt the adequacy of the model, rho 1 not equal to 0 and rho k equal to 0 for k greater than equal to 2. So here sample autocorrelations are helping us to determine to what extent we can consider the dependence relationship between the time series values. So, here the time series values are, so this is a first order series where ZT values are dependent upon the previous autocorrelations of lag K. This is non-zero. So these are the references. So for detailed derivations, you can refer to this fifth one, the Brockwell and That is, this example I have considered from the Anderson book. So, for detailed proof, you have to go to the chapter 7 of this Brockwell and Davis. So, thank you for enjoying the lecture. Hope that this will help you to study the distribution, estimation and distribution problems relating to the estimation of sample mean, estimation of sample, estimation of population mean, estimation of population covariance and population autocorrelations, autocovariance and autocorrelations. Thank you.